Subscribe and press the bell icon on the YouTube app to never miss an update from Shemaroo Kids Kannada. Shemaroo Kids.
Mohandas Karamchand Gandhi, also called as Mahatma and Bapu, was one of the greatest thinkers of the 20th century and the leader of India's independence movement. He practiced non-violence, ahimsa, and peaceful disobedience, satyagraha, to fight against the British in India. Gandhiji is also referred to as the father of the nation. Gandhiji was born on October 2, 1869 in Porbandar, Gujarat, to Karamchand Gandhi, a Diwan of Porbandar, and Putlibai, a deeply religious woman who taught him the values of fasting, meditation, vegetarianism, and non-injury to living beings. A shy boy who would run home from school, young Mohandas was soft-spoken and a mediocre student. As a kid, he displayed no leadership qualities, did not enjoy sports, had bad handwriting, and disliked public speaking. He spoke English with an Irish accent since he was studying under an Irish teacher. As he was weak in English, his teacher asked him to copy the Sermon on the Mount. This prayer, along with the stories of Shravan Kumar, King Harishchandra, and the Bhagavad Gita, taught Gandhiji humility, truthfulness, and forgiveness. In May 1883, 13-year-old Gandhiji married Kasturba Makanji, a merchant's daughter, in an arranged child marriage. He rebelled against this by smoking, eating meat, and even stealing. On August 10, 1888, he sailed to England to continue his education in law at the University College, London. Gandhiji had promised his mother to follow vegetarianism and abstain from alcohol. However, while in London, he tried his best to adopt the English customs by taking up violin and dancing classes, donning silk hats and suits, even learning French during his initial days. Gandhi met some renowned authors and thinkers like Leo Tolstoy and Henry David Thoreau at the London Vegetarian Society. Gandhiji returned to India in 1891 on completing his degree in law, but was unable to find employment. Thereafter, he moved to South Africa in 1893 to practice law. Gandhiji was 24 when he arrived in South Africa. He was shocked by the racial discrimination faced by blacks and Indians alike. Indians were treated as colored people and were not allowed even basic privileges, such as walking on public footpaths, staying in hotels, etc., among others. While traveling to Pretoria in 1906, Gandhiji was thrown out of the train for refusing to move from the first-class compartment. He was also kicked off a footpath by a police officer. Gandhiji once visited an English barber who refused to cut his hair, saying that he would go out of business if he attends to a colored man. This insult sank deep into Gandhiji's mind, who decided that he would rather cut his hair himself. Gandhiji bought a pair of clippers and cut his hair, which made him look like a rat had nibbled his hair to portray his disobedience. Gandhiji first practiced satyagraha in South Africa to fight for the civil rights of Indians. He gave up his law practice, dressed like a poor laborer, walked barefoot, and lived on only one meal a day. He was jailed several times for campaigning against racial discrimination. Gandhiji remained there until 1914, emerging as a leader of the Indian community. His law practice helped him to gain exceptional ease at public speaking, negotiating, and media relations. In 1915, after living 21 years in South Africa, Gandhiji returned back to India and joined the Indian independence movement at the request of Gopal Krishna Gokhale. He used ahimsa as a tool to boycott the British rule. He urged citizens to stop purchasing British goods and stop paying taxes. Using a charkha, or the spinning wheel, Gandhiji produced his own cloth. He wanted to show that Indians were deserving of independence and were determined to achieve it. Aurobindo Ghosh, Subhash Chandra Bose, and Bhagat Singh opposed Gandhiji's methods of non-violence, but Gandhiji was determined. Gandhiji had corresponded via letters with many people. The collected works of Mahatma Gandhi contains over 31,000 letters, some written by him to Count Leo Tolstoy, Romain Rolland, Albert Einstein, and Adolf Hitler. He also published many journals, Harijan in 1932, Young India
1919 to 1932, and Indian Opinion, a newspaper in South Africa. His famous autobiography, The Story of My Experiments with Truth, was considered as one of the 100 best spiritual books of the 20th century. Gandhiji was fond of walking and has walked over 79,000 kilometers, a distance that is enough to go around the earth twice. During the Dandi March in 1930, at the age of 60, he covered 390 kilometers from Sabarmati Ashram in Ahmedabad to Dandi, Gujarat. Gandhiji inspired millions of people around the world to adopt the principles of non-violence and civil disobedience. Martin Luther King Jr., Dalai Lama, Aung San Suu Kyi, Nelson Mandela, and Adolfo Perez Esquivel, all Nobel Peace Prize winners, followed Gandhiji's philosophy of peace. Gandhiji himself was nominated for the Nobel Peace Prize 5 times, 1937, 1938, 1939, 1947, and 1948, but never received the award. He also strived for equal rights to women, abolition of the caste system, and fair treatment of all people. Gandhiji led a simple way of living, wearing a dhoti, traveling on foot wherever possible, living in the slum areas of cities, and always using the cheapest class of railway travel. He had a set of false teeth that he carried in a fold of his loincloth, wearing it only while eating. He restricted his diet to fruit and nuts and undertook long periods of fasting as a means of both self-purification and social protest. Pair of round glasses and hand charkha are seen as symbols of Gandhiji's personality. Steve Jobs was a fan of Mahatma Gandhi. His round glasses were a tribute to the great leader. Gandhiji's vision of an independent India was wounded with the partition of British India into Hindu-majority India and Muslim Pakistan, leading to widespread religious violence. Gandhiji travelled to affected areas and undertook fasts unto death to promote religious harmony. Gandhiji was assassinated on January the 30th, 1948, while walking to a prayer meeting by Nathuram Godse. His memorial, Rajghat, in Delhi, has his famous last words, "Hey Ram," inscribed on it. His quote, "An eye for an eye makes the whole world blind," shows his love for peace. In 2007, the United Nations General Assembly declared October the 2nd, the birthday of the Mahatma, as International Day of Non-Violence.
Hi kids, hope you liked the video.
Subscribe for more fun videos.